On the Earth, we know the ocean, home to the octopus, the otter, and the orca. In the air above is the osprey, the oriole, and the owl. On land lives the opossum, the ocelot, and the ostrich.
Don't I belong with the birds in the air?
Well, yes, you are a bird, but you actually can't fly up in the air.
Oh.
Yes. Now, may I continue with the opening narration?
Oops.
Where was I? Oh, yes. In the air, we have the osprey, the oriole, and the owl.
An adventure with Olivia Owl. Olivia was a fluffy baby owl. Olivia felt lonely when she couldn't find anyone to play with.
I will just have to find another owl like myself, she decided.
So she set off to look. Olivia wandered past the pond. There among the reeds, she caught sight of something fluffy.
Excuse me, called Olivia. Are you an owl by any chance?
An owl, said Sally Signet.
Please, I am a baby swan.
Sally had never heard of an owl living on the pond, but she had seen something brown and fluffy by some mossy rocks in the stream. Perhaps it was an owl who had gotten lost. Olivia went to look.
Hello, she said. Are you an owl?
Not on your life, said Oscar Otter.
Oscar thought Olivia might have more luck looking in the woods.
Perhaps owls and trees go together, he suggested, looking at something fluffy in an old tree.
Not this time, said Pat Possum.
I know where there might be an owl, said Pat. Over there by those flowers. You can see the fluff from here.
They all hurried over, but
it was just Dilly Dormouse.
Olivia began to wonder if she would ever find another owl to play with. Just then, she saw something fluffy on the bank.
Hoo-hoo! But it was only Billy Bunny.
Perhaps you are just looking too low down, said Billy. Try looking up.
Is that an owl's wing, perhaps?
Oh, excuse me, said Ellie Eagle. That's my wing.
Now that she had found so many new friends, Olivia didn't feel so lonely. But she still wanted to find an owl.
I'll have one last look in this old barn, she thought.
Can you guess what she found inside?
Ooh! Ooh, hello, Olivia!
Ooh!
Ooh! Ooh! Ooh!
Now we know what lives in the air and on the earth. And in the ocean.
What about outer space?
I don't really know what lives in outer space, but this is the letter O week. Maybe we'll have the opportunity to find out.
Oportunidad.
Do you want to tell us about the short O sound?
The octopus, the otter, and the ox on stage performing opera. quite often with the fogs. And now, Yasmin, you do the long O, which has an O sound.
Olivia wore overalls and climbed the old oak tree. Oh, she said, over there. Is that the ocean that I see?
Palabras que empiezan con la letra O son orgánico,
organic,
observar,
observe,
original,
original,
y octava.
Octave! What's an octave?
Do you remember when we learned the word melody as the tones you can sing in music? An octave is how musical tones are grouped together. La 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 ma. The first note, la. And last note, ma, are actually the same note, one octave apart.
Do you mean like this?
My corona.
Yeah, but actually more like high and lower. Speaking of low and high, that reminds me of some more O words, like on and off. And those are opposites.
Opposites.
Big.
And small. Short.
And tall.
High.
And low.
Fast.
And slow. Heavy. Day
and night. In
and out.
Whisper
and shout.
Weak
and strong. Right,
wrong.
Hot
and cold. Young
and old.
Wet
and dry. Hello. Goodbye. Dragon, what's your name?
Night Dragon! I'm Yasmin.
That's a beautiful name. I don't mean to startle you. My heart has been following a signal that led me straight here.
We have been traveling for months on a mission to return this dragon egg.
You have a dragon egg? May I see? Wow. Where did you get it?
It appeared on top of our friend's house. Then a falcon left us a note ordering us to return the egg to the dragons. And here you are.
Well, I'm not your ordinary dragon. And this egg isn't mine. But La Niña said we had to find you to continue in our mission. So can you take us to the ordinary dragons? Probably not. I'm what you consider an outcast.
What does that mean?
It means he's not part of their order. He's an oddball.
Carmelo, that's not very nice.
He's right. My family doesn't consider me one of their own. They only want me to be obedient to their oath of taking over the planet. But they weren't born here. I was. Hold up, where did the dragons come from? It's an old story. You probably don't have time to hear it.
I love old stories, especially if they are out of this world.
Well, okay. According to my mother, she tells me that we originally came to this planet from outer space.
For us to travel to outer space, we have to close our eyes and go there in our mind. You'll have to imagine gravity as well as oxygen, so we can breathe and we don't float away. Close your eyes and let's prepare for liftoff.
Make ready to blast off. Fasten your safety belts and hold on tight.
All systems go. Minus 10 and counting. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift off. Space.
Attention! Earth passengers, please prepare for landing. Welcome to the first moon of planet Sirius X. When you disembark from the space shuttle, you will find yourself in a new environment. It may be one that you have never experienced before. Here, there is less gravity than on Earth. You will find that you are much lighter and are practically weightless. Things will seem to be going in slow motion. You will find that you can take giant steps and almost float through the air. Please be careful as you disembark.
We float freely about. Slowly. It feels just like we're swimming. Ever so lazily.
Oscar Otter. It was a beautiful morning down by the river. Oscar Otter was enjoying a swim when suddenly, out of the corner of his eye, he spotted a little goldfish. Oscar hurried over to say hello, but he was too late. The goldfish had gone. Oscar ducked his head underwater, but he couldn't see the goldfish anywhere. Then he saw something move among the rocks. "Aha! I found you," he thought. But when he got closer, he had a surprise. It wasn't a goldfish. It was Nellie Newt. "I have a friend who might know where to find a goldfish," said Nellie, leading Oscar to some rocks. "Oh, hello," said Vinnie Vole. "Can I help you?" But Vinny hadn't seen any goldfish either. Just as the friends were wondering where to look next, they were surprised by a big splash. Splash! It was Katie Kingfisher. "Perhaps the goldfish is over there by the dam," suggested Katie.
"Who
lives there?" asked Oscar curiously.
"I do," said Becky Beaver. "Hello, Oscar."
Becky hadn't seen any goldfish by the dam, but she had seen fish leaping in the waterfall.
"Can goldfish leap, do you think?" said Oscar.
"Ooh, not like me," said Sophie Salmon.
"I know the perfect place to find goldfish," said Sophie. She led Oscar to a pond full of beautiful water lilies.
"Oh, my word," gasped Oscar. "We're sure to find a goldfish here."
But they only found Terry Terrapin.
But there were no goldfish anywhere in sight.
"Dear, oh dear," said Oscar. "That goldfish must have gotten away."
But just at that very moment, up popped a whole shoal of goldfish. Whee!
Night Dragon, your origin story begins millions of years ago, when we dragons discovered your planet and began experimenting on it with our own offspring. They were like us, but without magical powers. You call them dinosaurs. And they ruled over the planet until one day, Earth was struck with an outside object that obliterated the entire species. We were heartbroken and vowed to return one day to take back what was ours. About 200,000 years ago, a small group of us returned with our original powers, too omnipotent to be observable to others, operating only in the imagination of believers.
We were told on Imagination Island that the dragons occupying Earth has caused much oppression.
It's true. They are so overbearing, it leaves an ominous odor in my olfactory senses.
That's why you were sent to be born in an offshore oasis, to open Earth to the option for an optimistic outlook.
But I'm not very optimistic about any of this.
Attention! Attention! All passengers, please return to the space shuttle. We are scheduled to visit the second moon of Sirius X immediately. Welcome to the second moon of Sirius X. The surface of this moon is covered with many sharp and jagged rocks. In addition, the ground is very hot. You will have to step quickly and carefully on this moon. Please be careful as you disembark.
I've heard about this place. Three things to look out for are the robots, the spaghetti boingers, and the clackers. If you hear them coming, you have to move like they move so they don't come after you. Here comes a robot. Start moving like they do. Oh no, it's the spaghetti boingers. Make your arms and legs move like a wet noodle.
Thank you.
into any clackers. Oh no! Don't let them clack you up! I don't think they noticed you. Wait! They're coming back!
Keep dodging those meteors. Don't stop moving.
Earthlings, hurry! Gather onto our ship.
Look at this technology. It's as if the spaceship itself is organic.
Yes, and we are obliged to return the favor. How may we assist you?
This space odyssey has been overwhelming. I think it's time we all come back down to Earth.
Oh, what an exciting array of goodies to do. We have a big O and a little O, and that's a mighty O. Tree. We're going to practice our O's. Follow the arrow going around and over here. That is an octopus. And, a hooty owl sitting in a big O swing. Oh, there's his friend. Here we have many things in that O. Can you find the orchid? The octopus, the otter, the olives, the owl, many, many things. Now, can you find the words for octopus, ostrich, otter, ox? You have to look in here and what's that? O-T-T-E-R. We found one otter. Then you practice your O's again. And how many complete O's are here? You can't count these. They're only partial O's. These and these and these. And don't forget this one. So count how many there are and put the number right there. We have orcas, oranges, octopus, ostrich. Oh, hello, Miss Ostrich. How are you doing? Well, she's looking over these pages like she's ready to start. Let's make our O book. We have to fill in all these O's, and we'll cut these in half and staple them inside an O book. Octopus, ostrich, otter, ox. And here are some more words that start with letter O. Only we're going to put them in a different format. They're going to be long. I cut out the first three because you have many pages to cut out. And what you can do is you can put opossum here and oval and octagon. And we're going to cut these. You can see the line, it goes in thirds. We'll put them all inside this book, and this will be a very big book of words that start with letter O. That's a small one over there, and that's a big long one. Just a different way to do it. And now, Mr. Otter, you are so cute. But we have a silhouette of you. We're going to take this cotton ball. We're going to dip it in some paint and bounce it along. And when we're all done, we're going to take it off. And you're going to get the painting of an otter. It might be helpful if you put a little tape on that. Now, let's figure this out. What does that look like to you? Oh, I see a number one, number two, number three, four, and five. Here's an O. Oh, there's a number one on the back. Okay, so we'll work with this one first. Where's number two? There's number two, so we'll put him on top. So we have two O's, one on top of each other. Then this is number three. Looks like eyes and a beak to me. Right on there. And then we have a number four wing. And a number five wing. And now you have just made your owl. Woo! And one more thing, we have an octave.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
In between are eight notes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That is called one octave in music. And these are your piano notes.
Words that have O-C-T in them, as in oct, means eight, like octopus, eight legs, or octagon, eight-sided shape. Octave, eight notes.
Yay! Ooh! That looks like a lot of fun to me. Ho, ho, ho!
One by Catherine Otoshi.
Blue was a quiet color. He enjoyed looking up at the sky, floating on the waves. And on days he felt daring, splashing in rain puddles.
Every once in a while, he wished he could be more sunny like yellow, or bright like green, more regal like purple, or outgoing like orange.
But overall, he liked being blue.
Except when he was with Red. Red was a hothead. He liked to pick on Blue.
Red is a great color, he'd say. Red is hot. Blue is not.
Then Blue would feel bad about being blue.
Sometimes Yellow comforted Blue. Blue is a very nice color, she'd say. But Yellow never said that in front of Red. She never said, "Stop picking on Blue." Green, purple, and orange thought Blue was nice too. But they never told Red to stop either.
Every time Red said something mean and no one spoke up, he got bigger and bigger and bigger. Soon, Red grew so big that everyone was afraid of him. No one dared stop him. Red picked on all the colors.
Then everyone felt
a little blue.
Until one came. He had a different shape with bold strokes and squared corners. He was funny. He made the colors laugh.
Hey, did you hear the one about the one? Well, you're hearing about me now.
Red saw this and got very hot. Stop laughing, he told Yellow. Stop laughing, he told Green. Stop laughing, he told Purple and Orange. And they did. Red rolled up to one. Stop laughing, he told him.
But one stood up straight like an arrow and said, no.
Red was mad, but one wouldn't budge, so Red rolled away.
One turned to the colors and said, if someone is mean and picks on me, I, for one, stand up and say no. Then Yellow felt brave and said, me too. Green agreed and said, me three. Then Purple became four, and Orange became five.
Blue saw the colors change. He wanted to count.
Red grew hot. He felt left out. He grew hotter and hotter and hotter. Red raced over to Blue and said what he always did. Red is hot. Blue is not.
But this time, Blue stood up tall and became six. Red can be really hot, he said, but Blue can be super cool.
Red blew a fuse and tried to roll over Blue.
But everyone took a stand and said,
no!
Seeing them standing tall made Red feel very, very, very small. Then Red turned even redder and began rolling away.
Blue called out, can Red be hot and Blue be cool?
Red stopped in his tracks.
Red can count too, said one.
Red rocked and rolled and turned into seven.
Everyone counts,
they all shouted.
Then Red laughed and joined the fun.
Sometimes it just takes one.